CCHL play resumes after the holidays as Fenwick visits Will Sammons and Benet Academy at Seven Bridges. The Friars have allowed the most goals in the conference this season. The Red Wings open up the scoring 2 minutes into the game. They get some good looks in front of the net before Mason Kozowski slides home the game's first goal. The Friars tie it up a minute later and then head in on the attack looking for the lead. Benet turns the puck over and Jack Guerra goes five-hole on A.J. Grisbeck to give Fenwick a 2-1 advantage. Under 5 to play in the first, Henry Neri drops it off for Anthony Claus and he snipes it into the back of the net. Game tied at 2 heading to the second period. Early in the second, Benet heads in on the fast break. They get the puck on net. Fenwick fails to clear. Charlie Chemlik's shot is saved, but Will Sammons is there for the rebound to give the Red Wings the lead. The Red Wings get another good look a few minutes later. Jack Peras gets the puck at the point, but whiffs on a couple shot attempts and the Friars clear. Not to worry though, as Peras regathers the puck, walks in and buries the slap shot to put Benet up 4-2. The second period is a big one for the Red Wings. Here they get the puck in deep, and then Caleb Jura hits JT Kelly in the slot for his 5th goal in conference play to give Benet a 3-goal cushion. Benet turns defense into offense here as Will Sammons forces a turnover and hits Mason Kozowski for his 2nd goal of the game. Red Wings lead by 4. All Red Wings in the second period. Luke Bentley wins a board battle for the puck from 2 defenders. He throws it on net and it eventually finds Tommy McDonald. He snipes it 5-hole on Francis Bertuca and Benet leads 7-2. 30 seconds later, Henry Neri goes right by a defender, giving himself a breakaway, and he roofs the backhand over Bertuca for his 5th goal in league play. Red Wings put up a big 7 spot in the second period. Caleb Jura gets between the circles and fires it into the back of the net. The Red Wings don't look back from there as they pick up 2 points and are tied with Providence Catholic for 2nd in the CCHL standings.
That was a tough way to start that goal, but came back down the ice all by myself. It was a good recovery by me. Nice slap shot in, so I felt good. Well, I think we just took it one goal at a time. We got one in, and then the goals just kept rolling in, and we just fed off of each shift, and it was a good game.
After the second or the first period, we came out. We started shooting the puck. We went to the net. We crashed. We got a lot of rebound goals. Lots of pucks. Getting to the high slot. Lots of shots. We started moving the puck better. Less selfish play. More moving it across the ice far side rather than, you know, everyone just skating it up by themselves.
I mean, I think it really shows, like Mason said before, that we have a lot of depth on our team, that we can really score a lot of goals and we're going to control this season. I think we really just started getting shots off the top and then it just started from there.
Well, we started stepping up more. We started playing the body. We started kind of soft. We let them in the zone most of the time, but towards the second period, we started to pick up the pace and start hitting them more. So that's how we improved.
For Naperville Sports Weekly, I'm Ryan Riske.